The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 13th chapter, text number 8 through 12, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on October 2nd, 1973, in Bombay, India.
Translation: Humility, pridelessness, non-violence, tolerance, simplicity, approaching a bona fide spiritual master, cleanliness, steadiness, and self-control, renunciation of the objects of sense gratification, absence of false ego, the perception of the evil of birth, death, old age, and disease, non-attachment to children, wife, home, and the rest, and even-mindedness amid pleasant and unpleasant events, constant and unalloyed devotion to me, resorting to solitary places, detachment from the general mass of people, accepting the importance of self-realization, and philosophical search for the absolute truth. All these I thus declare to be knowledge, and what is contrary to these is ignorance.
So, we have discussed about the body, Ketra, the question of Arjuna was Ketra, Ketrajna, Jnanam, and Gyanam. Now, Ketra, we have discussed yesterday, Ketra, this body, is combination of the five great elements, false ego, intelligence, the unmanifested, the ten senses, the mind, the five sense objects, desire, effect, happiness, distress, the aggregate delight, symptom, and convictions, all these are considered in summary to be the field of activity. This area of this stuff. So we should not mistake this, that we accept the field of activities identified with myself. That is the reason. Suppose you have got a piece of land as agriculture, and you produce your food grain in large quantity or small quantity, doesn't matter. Similarly, this body we are utilizing. We can practically see everyone is working with this body in Bombay city. A very poor man is also in Bombay city, and a very rich man is also there. Both of them have the same facilities to work, but we find that one man is working very hard day and night. Hardly he is getting his morsel of food. Another man, simply by going, sitting in the office, earning thousands and thousands. Why? Because the difference of the field of activity. The body is different. Because one has got a certain type of body. His destination is already there. Karmana daivana trena. Deho, janta deho upavatti. We can study this thing. That somebody is living in a poor slum, another man is living in a very palatial building. So, simply by endeavoring that I shall live in a palatial building, and I shall not live in this poor slum house, it is not possible, because the destiny is there. Therefore, the body is made according to our past karma, and that is called destiny. Your happiness and distress according to the body is already settled up. It is not possible by natural way to improve or disimprove it. It is already settled. Therefore, Shastra says, Tasyaiva heta prajateta komda nalabhate jad bhamatamu parajam kallabhate dukha vadannata sukham kalena sarvatra gavhidatam. The human life should be utilized for understanding the absolute truth. The next paragraph that describes how one can understand the absolute truth. Amaritam agamritam vahishatam vyajam. So our life should be utilized for understanding the absolute truth, not for economic development. Economic development, what is already destined, you cannot improve less or more. It is already settled. There are so many examples. Just like a pig has got a body, he likes to eat stool. If you give him halwa, then don't eat steam as stool. Take this nice halwa. He's not interested. Because he has got a particular type of bone. That is ambiguous, that is only this one. Mahabhutani ahankara buddhi rabbhakta. Ichhadesha sukham dukha. Ichhadesha. The ichhadesha according to the body. He has got the desire to eat this food, that is his ichha. And he has got a desha for the halwa. While a gentleman, advanced gentleman, he has got the ichha for halwa, not for this food. Therefore, our duty should be that without trying, that was Indian civilization. Everyone was happy in his position. As the Brahman, Kshatri, Vaishya, Shudra, the culture was so nice that nobody was unhappy. Even if he is a Shudra, or even if he is a Vaishya, or a Brahmana, Kshatriya, it is not that because the Kshatriyas, the royal family, they were happy and the Brahmanas were not happy. Or the Shudras were not happy. No. Everyone was happy. Because still in India, you go to the village, they are happy with their destination. This is the Indian culture. Now we are injecting this consciousness. Otherwise everyone was happy in his position. God has given this position. So, this is all right, let me do my work. That is satisfaction. Everyone is satisfied. Still it is going on. Although great propaganda is going on to kill the baby culture. Still some 1971, we attended the Bagh Mela. 1971 or which year? The people were coming there, thousands and thousands to take a bath in the Ganges, and they were happy. There, in Calcutta, there was a Indo-American society. I was invited to speak there. So they gave me the subject matter, East and West. So far we are concerned, we have no such distinction East and West. We know that everyone is human being, and every living entity, not only the human being, even the gods, beasts, animals, trees, everyone, a living entity is part and parcel of God, Krishna, Manimansa-jiva-bhuta. So everyone is in ignorance. That is our concern. Our propaganda is not for the East and the West, but our fight is with the ignorance of the people. Because at the present moment, people are kept in ignorance, in foolishness, that he is this body, bodily identity. But still, there is difference between East and West. In the West, I have talked with big professors, learned scholars. They have no idea of next life. I talked with Professor Prokofsky in Moscow. He said, Swamiji, after annihilation of this body, everything is finished. They have no idea that there is soul. And in India, even the poorest man, he knows that there is next life. I existed in the past, and I will exist in the future. This very conclusion is known even to the poorest man in little. That is, of course, the difference between East and West. So anyway, our position is that we should not identify this body as self. Krishna says here that Ujjyāko-jñāno-nityatvam tattva-jñānārtha-darśanam etat jnanam iti pruttam avjnanam jat ata anyatha. Ujjyāko jnanam, to understand oneself as the spirit soul, that jnanam. Ujjyāko jnanam tattva jnanartha darsanam. Philosophy should be utilized, logic and philosophy should be utilized for self-realization, not for simply mental speculation. We find nowadays big philosophers, like volumes of books, simply theorizing without any understanding of the spirit soul. Big philosophers. And Krishna says that if one simply puts philosophical theories for some utopian ideas, now, as time is coming, we will be like this, like that. No. Time is there already. You cannot manufacture time like this or like that. It will go off. It is eternal. It is eternal, just like Krishna has said in the second chapter of Bhagavad Gita, that although you and me and all the soldiers and kings who are assembled here, it is not that we did not exist in the past, we are existing now, and we shall continue to exist in the future. So, this eternity of the soul, we do not know. We are simply identifying ourselves with this body, and we are simply interested for the bodily comforts of life. This is the civilization of Veda. So although we have got this Bhagavad Gita, at least in India, the education should have been on the line of Bhagavad Gita for the benefit of the people of India. Unfortunately, nobody is taking care. Even though there are some propaganda of understanding Bhagavad Gita, they are interpreting in their own way to fulfill their own ambition. This is very good. So, here Krishna says, amanittam, what is it, amanittam? The central point of process of knowledge is mentioned here, mayicha ananna yogena bhakti abhyadichari. One has to be fixed up on this point. There are 18 different descriptions of the process of knowledge. But the central point is moi cha. Moi cha na means that is the main point. Without Krishna, if you simply try to become elevated in knowledge, that will not stand. That will not stand. Therefore Krishna says, Moicha ananna yogena. Ananna yogena means without any deviation. Ananna yogena bhakti. Abhyacharini. Without any deviation. Abhyacharini means without any disturbance. Ananna bhakti. In another place Krishna says, Okiche Sudurachara Bhagate Mam Ananava. Okite Sudurachara Bhagate Mam Ananava. Sadhureva Samantaka. Sampak Bhagavatarisa. The center point is Bhagavad Bhakti. Arava Bhakta Satuto Mahatmuna. If one is not a devotee of the Lord, Krishna, Harava Bhaktasya Kuto Mahaduguna, he cannot possess any great qualities, that is not possible. Harava Bhaktasya Kuto Mahaduguna. We have seen practically that Ravan was a great personality, a great devotee of Lord Shiva also, and materially, his kingdom was very much advanced. It is said that the Lanka was made of gold. Naturally, there were many palaces, and he was a very big Vedic scholar. But one thing, that he was against Rava. And for this disqualification, he is still described as Asura, Rakshasa. So, Rava Bhaktasya Kuto Mahatmana. Munorakena Satodhagutudu. If one is not devotee of the Lord, he will simply compact on the mental platform. That will not matter. Ravana also wanted to make a staircase to go directly to the heavenly planet. Just like we are, at the present moment, we are trying to go directly to the moon planet by Sputnik. But it has failed. It is not possible. In that way we cannot go. If we want to go to another planet, the process is described in the Bhagavad Gita. Janti deva, deva bhrata deva. Pitrin janti pitrin bhrata. If you want to go to the higher planetary system, then that particular deva, Indraloka, Chandraloka, the moon planet, Chandraloka, that is also considered as one of the heavenly planets. So you have to prepare yourself by karmakandya activities. Then you can go there by after this body is finished, you immediately transfer to certain planet where you want to go. Similarly, if you want to go to the planet where Krishna lives, Goloka Vrindavan, Goloka Narni Mijadham Nikare Tatasya Devi Mahesa Haridham Surteshu Teshu Tetit Prabhava Nitraya Vintasya Jena Govinda Madhikursam Samam Vajana. There is Parastasmattu Bhavayanya Vaktya Vaktya Sanatana. They are described in Bhagavad Gita. Beyond this material nature, there is another nature. That is called Sanatana. Parastasmattu bhava means sabhava or nature. As you see this material nature, although you are seeing, you cannot go. You are so limited, conditioned. You see so many planets twinkling at night, but there is no possibility of going there. You cannot go to the nearest planet, in the moon planet, by your mechanical arrangement. The modern scientists, the Sputniks, experts, they say, to go to the topmost planet of this universe, it will take 40,000 years. Who is going? For 40,000 flying, 40,000 years and again come back and see you. Yes, I went to such and such planet. Is it possible? So we are so poor. It is not possible in that way. So this is the position of our going to the material planets. And what to speak of the spiritual planets. That is far, far away. You cannot travel within the space of material world. Panthasta koti satavasya sampravamba. Vayura thapi madaso maripungavana. So first is a parvadasena avichinta tatte govinda manikulitam tamapulaya. Panthasta koti satavasya. Not only 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, or 40,000 years. Koti satavasya. Koti, you know, 100 times less makes koti. And again, multiply it by 100. Koti satavasva. And the speed, what is the speed of that aeroplane? Panthas koti satavasva sampradamma bayurathapi. Aeroplane, bayurmanasa. And with the speed of mind, airplane running with the speed of mind. You know what is the speed of mind? You are sitting here, and within a second, your mind can go some 10,000 miles away. Within a second. So, in with that speed, and running on for 40 shatavasra, you cannot go to the spiritual plan. This is the thing. So, first is after the sin of which in that way you cannot go. But you can go if you prepare yourself. Madhyajina pijantima. Madhyajina. Those who are devotees of the Lord. Madhyajina. That is the principle of Bhagavad Gita. Manvana bhava madhvatta madhyajina. Madhyajina, worship me. So madhyajina pijantima. You can go to the Krishna planet. Goloka nāmi nijathāmi karishtas. The Krishna nāmi is described in the Shastra, Brahma Samhita. Cintāmani sakara sadana sukalpa vrikkalakthā prite susura bhīra vipālentam lakshmi sahasra sata sambrama sirpamānam govindam ādhisultam tavam bhajam. There is the Goloka Vrindavan planet. The Guru Govindam planet is the topmost planet. This material world, then you will get spiritual world. The spiritual world, as you have got in this material world, this is only one universe. There are millions of universes, even within this material world. Just say, Nishasita Kalama Kavalamba, Jivanti Loma Viloja Jagadanda Natha. Just say, Nishasita Kalama Kavalamba. People claim, some rascal claim, I am God. Here is the description of God. Just say the nishasita kalama of abalamba, jivanti loma vilaja, jagadanda natha. Jagadanda natha means Brahma. You have understood Brahma's duration of life. Sahasra yugapadjantam arahajjad Brahma no vidu. The Brahma's one day, 12 hours, you cannot calculate. Sahasra Yuga. Yuga means about 53 lakhs of years and multiplied by 1,000. And then it comes to be 12 hours of Brahma's eye. Such Brahma lives only in the sake of Nishasuta Kalama Phala. Mahavishnu is excelling and inherent. When he inherits, so many Brahmas are going with him. And when he's exhaling, so many Brahmas are coming. When so many Brahmas are coming. This is the position. The sake of Nishasita Kalama Thavalamba Jivanti Loma Viloja Jagadanda Natha Vishnu Mahan Jayar Kala Vishesa Govindamadi Purusantava. That Mahavishnu is partial representation of Govinda. Govinda Madhipurusam Tavahandasam. So, this is called knowledge. One has to know what is God, what is the nature of God. So, one has the first qualification is amanittam. Don't be puffed up with your false knowledge. Having this little degree from university, you are thinking that you have become so learned, you don't care for God. This is nonsense. Therefore, first qualification to make progress in knowledge is amanittam. Amanittam. Don't be proud falsely. Our present education is simply teaching people how to become falsely proud. Just like here Bhagavad Gita is going on. They are falsely proud. What you have to learn here? We know everything. We know everything. You are having PhD. That's all. You have finished all education. Therefore, the first thing is amanittam, pridelessness.
So, if one does not approach or is not able to approach the transcendental service of the Lord, then the other 19 items are of no particular value. But if one takes the devotional service in full Krishna consciousness, the other 19 items automatically develop within him.
Yes. This is the central point. This Shastri Bhakti Bhagavati Akinjana Sarvai Gunaitattva Samasate Pura. All the qualities of the demigod, Sura, Sura no Sura. Sura means demigods or gods, and Asura means demons. So, if one becomes devotee of Krishna, this Shasti Bhakti Bhagavati Akinchana, Akinchana, pridelessness. Akinchana, Krishna's another name is Akinchana Gochara. He can be understood by Akinchana, one who thinks himself as very humble means. That is also said in the Bible, that one has to become meek and humble, then he can understand. And that is also Krishna demanding. The first surrender, become humble and meek. This is the verdict of all Vedic sadhus. Jnani priyasam mudupasam namantayiva. Sarvaparitana bhavadiyavartam. This is the statement of Brahma. That one should give up the nonsense process of mental speculation. God may be like this, God may be like that. No. God is not manufactured by your mental speculation. God is God, always. Krishna. Krishna is God from the child. When he was 3 months old, he demonstrated his godly power. He immediately came. Sapatashu, he immediately came, Kutona. So he did not become God by meditation, manufactured in some mystic fashion. God is God. God is always God. Even when he is child, when he is young man, when he is a boy, Krishna, when he was a boy of 7 years old, he lifted the Govardhan hill. That is God. Not that here is a man, by mystic power he has become God. No, that God is different God. Real God is always God. That real God can be realized by person who is humble and meek. Amanittam, adambittam. There are 19 items automatically developed. Just Shasti Bhakti Bhagavata Akinchana Sarvai Gunai Tattva Samasati Sura Atrati. Jasmin Vidyate Sarvamedam Vidyatam Bhavanti. This is the Vedic assertion. If you simply understand one, that Krishna, then you understand everything. Just like in Bhagavad Gita. If you try to understand Krishna, you get all the knowledge, material, spiritual, everything. Practical. Just mean vijyate sarvamidam vijyatam bhavati.
The principle of accepting a spiritual master, as mentioned in the 7th verse, is essential.
Yes. The knowledge has to be acquired. Acharyopasanam. Here it is said. You have to worship acharya. Acharyaman purusa veda. one was accepted. Nathanas Thakur has also said, Ashray Loija Bhaje Krishna Tare Nahi Taju. Arsha More Okar. Ashray, you have to take shelter. Even Parampara Pratam, Pratam, even Raja Sahib. And Arjuna also said, Shishasteham Sadhiman Prapanyam. Shishas Acharya, Acharya Upasana. Krishna and Arjuna, two friends, there was no need of accepting Krishna as Arjuna's spiritual master. Still, he is accepting officially. Shishasteham Sadhiman Prapanyam. I am accepting you as my spiritual master. Please teach me. So this is essential. Acharya Upasana. Tad vijnanartham sa guru meva avivacchet. This is basic instruction. If you are at all interested in the understanding of spiritual subject matter, then you must approach a bona fide spiritual master. Tad vijnanartham sa guru meva avivacchet. Avivacchet means must. It is not that if you like, you can go. If you do not like, you do not. No, you must. Avigatshe. Samit pani suryam brahman. Tasmad gurum prabaddhita. Jigyasu sreya uttama. It is not a fashion to accept one guru. If you are actually interested, sreya uttama, the highest perfection of life, tasmad gurum prabaddhita, then you have to accept the guru. This is called acharya upasana. You know, Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, he accepted Sandipuni Muni, his teacher, master. Tekarno Mahaprabhu, he is also an incarnation of Krishna, but he accepted Ishwarpuri as his guru. They do not require guru, but just to keep pace with the official program, even God, personally, he accepted spiritual master. So, this is essential. Acharya Upasana. To become humble, to me, ahimsa, non-violence, kranti, tolerance. In this way you have to make progress. The other 99 items will be described. By tomorrow you shall describe.